ब्रेकिंग न्यूज, श्री के संतानम, MABL, चेयरमैन, फाइनेंस कमीशन, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, प्रिजाइडेड ओवर द 16th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लोकेटेड इन कुंभकोणम, तमिलनाडु, ऑन द 30th ऑफ अक्टूबर 1957. Let's have a look at the man behind this organization.
What they say. A visiting Fulbright professor in India during the period 1955-56, Professor Clarence E. Glick, professor of sociology, wrote appreciating this modern establishment with regard to the products manufactured and the services offered here. Dr. S. M. A. Muthiah Chettiar appreciated the punctual manner with which the services of this organization were operated and the man behind it all. Sir C. P. Ramaswamy Iyer appreciated the goodwill and understanding which prevailed between the workers and the management. Mr. P. Reed from London mentioned about the historical past of this organization, whereas Mr. H. J. Stokes, Controller Government Press, Madras, mentioned about the hard work of the man behind the organization and its leading position in the transport industry of South India during the 1950s. Of its director, Mr. A. M. P. Thiruvambalam Chettiar, Municipal Chairman, Nagapattinam, referred to the organization as a lifeline that connected people and places. Mr. S. A. Ayaswamy Chetty, Chief Presidency Magistrate, Madras, appreciated the manner in which the rights of the employees were safeguarded by the man who established the organization. Mr. A. Y. S. Parusitha Nadar, MLA, Chairman, Municipal Council, appreciated the meticulousness with which the operations were executed and the promptness of service of this organization. Mr. T. M. Narayanaswamy Pillai, MABL, Vice Chancellor, Annamalai University, appreciated this man's leadership and community services. Mr. S. A. Ayaswamy Chetty, Tube Investments of India Limited, appreciated the success of the organization. He owed it to the relationship which existed between the management and its workers. T.S. Rajagopala Iyengar, Chairman, Municipal Council and Proprietor, T.S.R. and Co., Kumbakonam, appreciated the commercial importance and the service of this organization to South India. Mr. A.T. Oliphant, Deputy Manager, Singapore, Traction & Co. Limited, expressed his pleasure of having had the opportunity to meet the man who was able to establish a wonderful relationship with his workers, whereas another customer, Mr. V. R. Murthy from Homeo House, recorded his connection as a customer of the organization and his pleasant experience. Dr. Wolfgang Scheer from IIT Madras, in his article The Lost Rod, wrote about his accidental experience having had the opportunity to meet the man and his luck in coming across the modern equipped service workshop similar to those which existed in his home country, Germany. Whereas another traveler, Dr. Ernest Schoenfield from Bern, Switzerland, has written about the hospitality which he received from this man in 1964 during his travel across India. Mr. Avvai T. Shanmugam, a renowned artist from Tamil Nadu, in his article has mentioned that the organization is a good place to learn and gain knowledge about industrial work. Dr. Sir C. P. Ramaswamy Iyer, who delivered the presidential address in 1956 in connection to the 15th anniversary of this organization, began his speech as he greeted Sir Ananta Ramakrishna Iyer and Sir Arokyaswamy as he spoke about how the organization was started in the middle of the devastating World War in 1956. 1941, growing to establish 26 bus routes operating 24 hours with a mileage of 9,000 per day. 3S Anantharamakrishna Iyer, Chairman, Amalgamations Group, Board of Directors, SRVS, Sri Ramavilas Service, in his speech on the occasion of the 16th anniversary celebration in 1957, thanked his colleague and district manager, Mr. Arakiswamy Pillai, and all his 800 workers for their excellent work in Kumbakonam. Mr. Arakiswamy addressing the workers of SRVS as they cheer him as he speaks. During the 1950s, Mr. Kamarajar visited Sri Ramavilas Service, SRVS. Mr. Arakiswamy is seen to greet Mr. Kamaraj with Mr. Bhaktavasalam and Mr. C. Subramanian. You can also see them sitting in an electric car that was modeled in the 1950s. The pictures which feature here are newspaper clips. The one in the center features Tandai Periyar with the tollers of SRVS. You also have actor M.R. Radha along with Mr. Arakiswamy. The other clips are about his visit to Malaysia, Singapore, a birthday celebration and with a governor and his wife. The photo on the top left corner is Mr. R. Venkatraman with Mr. Arakiswamy. The next one below it is Mr. Arakiswamy sitting in a toy car, a fully operational one during the 1950s. At that point of time, importing cars was very expensive, and it was SRVS, Sri Ramavilas Service, and TMT, Tanjore Motor Traders, who had the license for importing cars. Of course, it was SRVS Kumbakonam who was the district dealer for Morris and Roots Group, such cars as Rover, etc. In fact, Mr. Arakiswamy was the importer in the late 1928. During his wedding in 1934, Arakiswamy had a Rio car. The REO stands for Reynolds. This was later on taken over by General Motors. The next one below it features Mrs. Ladin, Mrs. Maria Deola Arakiswamy, and Mr. Ladin along with Mr. A. Victor. Meet the man behind the desk, the man behind the industry, Mr. S. Arakiswamy, Director and District Manager of Sri Ramavilas Service, SRVS Kumbakonam. To quote in the words of Mr. Maria Joseph from Loyola College, who describes him as a person, a handsome man, a person with a graceful demeanor, athletic body, dressed with smart white immaculate and with a formidable neatness around him, a realist. That is Mr. Arakiswamy Vandeyar, or at times called Mr. Arakiswamy Pillai. He brought together the Kshatriya community, the Mukkulathor, Devar, Kallar and Maravar. He also brought the Rotary Club International to Kumbakonam. To this day, some of the descendants of this family engage themselves in building the community and towards social welfare. Mr. Andrew Rosario works even now tirelessly to help people affected and suffering from corona. Whereas Mr. Anish Anthony Arakiswamy opened his bungalow in Velankani during the times of tsunami to shelter the poor and needy. And very silently, without much ado, keeps serving people with food who walk to the doors. The life of an ancestor is history. It has examples and shows us a path. However, we cannot live in their shadows. One has to emerge from the shadows and create his or her legacy, extending valuable support and building the community.
The life this man reminds me of a few lines from Shelley's Osmandius. Whenever I listen to the life history of this particular person. 4. Life is worth when we live. After after us. Who knows who would truly remember us? That's a thought for you.